development partners, senior government officials, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, and also importantly and not the least, Minister of Health officials and leadership that are here that are very important in implementing this plan. It is a pleasure for me this morning to officially launch this strategic plan, and I've seen it in its early conception and during its difficult times of pregnancy. Within the last 1 year, was 1 year rather than 9 months, and to actually see it come to the fore. I remember actually having this plan come to my office 3 times, and 3 times I called the permanent secretary and we discussed it. I know for sure that the permanent secretary had a 3 times 3 when brought to our office and sent back to Bunyama. But at the end of the day, we all are in agreement that the plan is exactly what we want to share. I want to begin by sharing with you the strategic direction of health set by the government. The government has a vision to see that every Fijian has access to health and also receives fair and equitable health services that is affordable. And I'll give you a great example. A great example is when the measles outbreak happened last year. It didn't happen in Nandi, it didn't happen in Suva, it happened in Wanendo in Namosi. And we had the capability within Seru and Namosi to be able to contain the measles outbreak, to do ring fencing, to do contact tracing, and to effectively try and shut it down within Seru and Namosi. Even though we had breaches, we had 2 villages outside of Seru and Namosi and up in Naitasiri that had the measles, but it was effectively controlled in Seru and Namosi. And that is because, as I said earlier, government has a vision that everyone in Fiji has access to health and receives fair and equitable health services. The strategies are closely aligned to the National Development Plan that emphasizes inclusive socio-economic development to improve the social well-being of all Fijians and with no one being left behind. The vision of a high-quality health system where medical services are raised to international standards is also reflected in this strategic plan. The strategic priorities set the pace in progressing towards universal health coverage and attaining the Sustainable Development Goal by ensuring that no one is left behind. This is further supported by systems strengthening at all levels to raise the quality of health services delivered through our facilities. I would like to ensure that every individual in this nation has equitable and accessible health services. Interacting with staff and peoples provide that platform to work towards accomplishing the desired goal. The strategic framework has been developed after extensive situation analysis to gauge where Fiji is in terms of global health indicators. This evaluation of where we are has facilitated the development of a document outlining where we want to be in 2025, which is the plan that is here before us. It clearly demonstrates our pathway to achieving universal health coverage by ensuring that we reach the unreached. And the beauty about universal health coverage is both public health and clinical medicine have a role to play. Both public health and clinical medicine can be integrated in this plan. Both public health and clinical medicine, with administration and finance supporting them, collaborate. And that's the beauty about universal health coverage and the beauty about this plan. This strategic plan provides overall strategic direction for Fiji's health sector over the 5-year period from 2020 to 2025. It is an overarching document that presents our vision, a healthy population, which is an all-encompassing statement. Our mission is to empower Fijians to achieve health and well-being through the delivery of a cost-effective, quality, and inclusive health services. This statement aptly captures our core business, system improvement focus, and the essence of inclusiveness in our service delivery to reach the unreached. Our strategic plan, therefore, is organized to the 3 broad strategic priority areas: population health, the services, and the health system strengthening. The first strategic priority is based on reforming public health services to provide a population-based approach for diseases and the climate crisis. We will do this through an integrated approach to public health. Core to this is ensuring we seek ways to expand the availability of promotive, protective, and preventive care throughout Fiji. By improving environmental health and reducing the risks of public health emergencies, we aim to reduce the burden of communicable diseases. This falls under our responsibilities to enforce international health regulations. The focus is to prevent, protect against, control, and provide a public health response to the spread of diseases. I've been very grateful seeing the effect of the many public health campaigns that have been held or been done over the last 1.5 to 2 years. we've seen our public health staff, whether they be doctors, health inspectors, nurses, even the allied health, with the support of the corporate staff, the drivers, going out into the communities, doing cleanup campaigns, looking at issues of wash, advocating for health. And we've seen it in the significant reductions in our leptospirosis, typhoid, and dengue at the beginning of this year. And that is a testament to the hard work that is being done around communicable diseases. And we need to continue doing that. One thing that I keep on sharing within this ministry and as we continue to discuss is that the normative functions of the Ministry of Health must carry on and carry on very well. We must ensure that this plan is done and done very well. On the other side, we must be able to take head on the extra normative functions that we face, like the measles campaign, like the cyclones that we had, and like the COVID-19 that is before us. And the great thing again about this plan is that it's telling us how we're going to approach both the normative functions and deal with the actual normative functions that we often face. The second strategic priority focus area is on access to quality, safe, and patient-focused clinical services, with a special focus on strengthening patient services and the continuum of care. We are seeking ways to expand the availability of care in communities, innovative ways to do this for people living in hard-to-reach locations. We will continue to use FEMAT as a platform and as a coordinating body to provide surgical outreach. Our outreach services for routine clinical services and rehabilitative services are also very important in supporting clinical services delivery by bringing services closer to communities and people's homes. The decentralization of specific services to divisions will assist us in achieving our aim of reduction in complications, as our people will be able to access services more efficiently. We acknowledge the importance of health systems and the need to drive efficient and effective management. The third strategic priority focus, therefore, is on building strong systems to support our public health and clinical services. We will continue to cover WHO health systems building blocks and have expanded the area of focus to include partnerships. We will seek innovation and evidence to improve our efficiency and effectiveness. We will strengthen the collaborative approach between stakeholders to better use resources and information in order to build a more resilient health system. Overall, the population level, service level, and systems level improvement we want to achieve through this plan will contribute towards our goal of achieving universal health coverage in Fiji. Ladies and gentlemen, that document is ready. The next step is implementation. If we are to succeed, it will be together as a network of partners who recognize that each sector of the society has a role to play in influencing population health. In addition, I'd just like to finish with two things. I want us as the Ministry of Health and Medical Services, and I'm glad that the partners are listening today, to bring about a change in the culture, to bring humanity back into this ministry, to see those values that are written here, accountability, excellence, inclusiveness, integrity. These are values that are not only this plan, but they are part and parcel of our Fijian way of life. They are part and parcel of our culture. We are an inclusive nation. We are a nation that has respect for one another. We are committed to the cause. And I want to see us bring about that cultural change within the Ministry of Health. And that cultural change begins with me. That cultural change begins with the Permanent Secretary. We must show respect, commitment, and compassion, and acceptance and tolerance for each other. Secondly, I want us, as I've said earlier in the plan, to continue to push universal health coverage. Universal health coverage is an acceptable mandate. It is a mandate that the United Nations has accepted. It's a mandate that WHO has accepted and advocated. It is a mandate that is reasonable, that is a mandate that is in line with the dreams and visions of this government. That is, we will reach the unreached, and we will leave no one behind. God bless you, and thank you very much.